Hey, what's up guys? Brian here, Brian's Law Maintenance. All right, today we're talking about the Ballard Advance Chute Blocker. This is actually take two because we just had the customer come out and she's like, what are you guys doing? I'm like, we're filming a quick video on this brand new chute blocker that keeps some grass clippings out of the beds. And she goes, thank God, even better, finally. She was so excited, wasn't she, Rob?
That's she was excited about it.
She's like, I want to see what it's all about. All right, for real. So this is the Ballard Chute Blocker. You can get them at ballard-inc.com. Brian's son saves 10%. You guys know what the deal is, right? So here's the deal. I've seen these for a while from all of you guys and on Instagram and all this other stuff. So let's look at this really quick. We're gonna show you guys it in action as well. We're gonna cut this front lawn. So here is the actual chute blocker. It's mechanically designed. It's on this little pivot. Got the spring that keeps it open or keeps it closed. We are covered in grass. So right now we're mowing 2 weeks of growth. The grass is literally 6 inches tall. In a second here, I'm gonna show you guys a quick little clip as well of us mulching leaves with it that I did in that backyard. Minced them to a pulp. It was awesome. So really quick here, I'm gonna show you guys some straight footage. We've got these beds here that we're gonna go in between. This is one of the more compact lawns that we have with the beds, including this little aisle here, for example. So 99% of you guys that mow grass need to get a chute blocker. If you don't have one, I don't know how you're doing it, right? By the way, this little handle here, there was a self-tapping screw. Then we went to a bolt with a wing nut. We got to get another one in there because it vibrated out. All right, so Rob, you want to show it in action here? through here. By the way, this is five inches of tall grass. It is wet, it is nasty. Here is us going at full throttle. We could have cut the blades down a little bit. This is the grass that we have in the bed. Very, very, very minimal. Now you did see a lot of grass flying up, I'll give you that. It just, you know, it's going up, it's circling, but it's still gonna leave a grass like windrow. You know, obviously we're gonna cut through here twice just to kind of mince it up a little bit more, but I think it's great. If you guys, I actually got a couple questions that you guys submitted via Instagram. So do you guys run the Ballard Advance Chute Blocker, or do you guys also have like the Qwikchute or the Xmark OCD? Here's a couple questions you guys asked. Is the handle in the way? So Rob, this is where it's going to be when we have the bolt in here, right? I know it's kind of raggedy here, but we're doing this as we go, just like you guys are. So here's the deal. The handle can be a little in the way, but the reality is that it's going to be out of the way 95% of the time because you're running it wide open, right? So the handle is not really an issue. Another question I got was, how much does this stick out? And you can see ours is basically parallel with the deck. Okay, so it's not hanging over. So we actually have a property that the gate is what, 62 inches, Rob? So we cannot get our traditional X-mark there with the OCD because we have to pop the OCD off, put it on the platform, and scrape through this deck at 61 inches. So the way ours is mounted, at least, there's no extra spacing on it. And again, the handle is gonna be facing inward. When you do tighten your handle down, just make sure that it's sticking in. But Rob, come over here from the parallel side again. You can see that it does stick out a little bit when it's open, but that's up to you guys if you want to use this extended handle as well. But when it's open, the handle's inward, so it shouldn't be an issue. All right, another thing we talked about earlier, or at least I think we did, was the fact that we put a wing nut on here. So you can put a bolt on there with a nylon washer, but Rob made a really good observation earlier that when we are going through like fenced areas and we have to pop this handle off, that a wing nut and a bolt is a better way to go, because then we can take off that extended handle in case it is jutting out too far. Another question, have you guys used a different brand? Qwikchute, Advance Chute, GrassFlap, the Easy Gates, whatever. They'll have their pros and cons. I'm not just gonna say that was like the best one. I used the Qwikchute, I enjoyed it. The mechanism was kind of different, but it was okay. I don't like the grass flaps in the Xmark OCD, for example, because it runs the cables. Those flex and they break over time. I'm not saying they are gonna break this year or in your first season with it, but over time you gotta keep replacing those cables, and they stretch, so you gotta keep like the tension on the platform and the chute. It gets a little annoying. What else we got? My allergies are going crazy right now. Mulching blades or ripper blades. So I'll show you that clip right now of us mulching in the backyard. These are standard razor blades, the Ballard razor blades, the lawnmower blades, okay? And it's already mincing with blades, or the leaves like crazy and the grass like crazy. If we had the ripper blades in here or the X blade setup, that would be incredible. So we have not added a mulching blade. It's not choking out the deck or anything like that. It's been going good. Another question was, how are the holes? Rob, can you come under here? So the top row is probably flush with this deck part. So these holes aren't really like even getting any, you know, grass on them, but the rest of these holes, they are getting caked. We can take the Ballard scraper and scrape this off if we want. Overall though, you can see they're getting plugged up a little bit. You'd power wash it once a week or once a day, and or like I said, just use a scraper on the back and it shouldn't be an issue. One other thing I have written down here, Brian's 10 code. I don't know why I wrote that down, but if you want to save 10%, you guys can order them at ballard-inc.com. All right, long story short, we're keeping this thing open, wide open 95% of the time when we're mowing. You can see the beds that we just did. I'm telling you guys what, if you know mowing grass, this is a really tight whole front yard. We always get grass everywhere. No grass clippings in here. Of course, we're gonna have to blow all this. This was 5-inch tall grass. It's 2 weeks of growth. Saturated lawns, in the shade, very wet. No grass here, no grass in this bed. Everything's contained. I mulch basically this whole front. That's awesome. The Xmark one doesn't really do that, okay? All right, if you guys have questions, leave them down below. I'll try to answer them the best I can. They should fit pretty much every mower, like the commercial mowers. And then one other thing here, Rob, I'm gonna point out, the mounting plate for ours is, let me pop this deck up a little bit. You guys might be able to see, the mounting for ours is about even to maybe a quarter inch above the bottom of the deck. Okay, so there is a little bit of like blowout opportunity, but that's okay. That way it's not choking down the deck. One other thing too, if your deck rounds like on the, maybe the Ferris's, trying to think like the Simplicity mowers, the deck kind of rounds back where the opening is. There's a little guard here, Rob, that comes back. And it's another plate that you bend, and that's going to give you that extra protection for any of the decks that kind of have the back right discharge, all right? So check it out. That's what we got. We'll show you maybe some more footage with it in action here. And if you guys enjoyed the video, big thumbs up. BallardDashInc.com, you can get them there. Brian's 10. Thanks for the support, by the way, for all of you guys that are picking up this product or all the other products. Super appreciate the support. My allergies are kicking in. I got to get out of here. You good, Rob?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Cut. Can't start until I got the Tic Tacs, even if it's a YouTube video.